in theory, like them leaving us with nothing after the CARES Act for month after month after month after month, wouldn't have been as bad if they're like, okay, we're not gonna do anything for you, but we are gonna try to get the disease, the numbers of infections and deaths to go down. So we're gonna encourage lockdowns, we're gonna encourage masks and everything. But they didn't do that either. It was, we're not gonna give you the money. We're gonna pretend that stopping the lockdowns will stimulate the economy, but we're gonna do everything we can to spread the disease as much as possible. So a lot of people get sick and die, and that'll hurt the economy. So really, it's the worst of both worlds. You get no government aid, and you have a high chance of getting sick or dying. That's what they've given us so far. And now the most recent insult. So Senate Republican Whip John Thune said that there could be language in the deal aimed at addressing concerns that people who receive both enhanced unemployment benefits and stimulus checks would be getting a double benefit. Okay, you can't just say, and look, it's not, that full thing isn't a quote from John Thune. So whoever wrote this in The Hill is sort of saying it. Addressing concerns. Who has those concerns? That was literally not even a thing I was thinking about. And I haven't heard a lot of people like, we want a government aid, but we don't want too much of it. Help us, but not double. That those are not concerns that anyone has, except perhaps Senate Republican Whip John Thune.
Yeah, I mean, those concerns are clearly not from the senator. Those concerns, I mean, from the people. Those concerns are from the senator. Those concerns are from the politicians. I don't understand how they can be so callous and so just so removed from what it's like for regular people who aren't making a six-figure salary or more. To say they're gonna be getting double benefit. I mean, and some of this aid is coming in food stamps. Some of this, I mean, Medicare, it's really unconscionable to have people act like if people are benefiting so much when families are being decimated, people are sick in the hospital. Let's even take aside the over 300,000 people that have died. We have people that are ill, not even just hospitalized people, people who have COVID that are stuck at home and are still sick. I think Ellen DeGeneres just, not that she's an angel, but she, you know, she has COVID. We don't want her to be ill, obviously, but she's a prominent person who just reported that she's having severe back pain. You know, and she had some back problems years ago. So who knows all of the different things that are wrapped up in getting this illness. And we're just shrugging our shoulders. We have the senator just saying, you know, we don't want them to get double benefits. And these are people barely scraping by. Yeah. It's callous, it's sad, and it's really disgusting.
Yeah. Well, look, as we acknowledged earlier, as bad as this final deal looks like it's gonna be, the only reason it isn't worse is because we do have at least some people in government who took a stand earlier this week saying they weren't gonna support a bill that masqueraded as trying to help people out, but didn't actually provide direct benefits, the survival checks, the enhanced unemployment insurance, those sorts of things. I wanna show you one great example of that, which is Representative Ilhan Omar. Here she is talking about the state of the bill.
It's really quite shameful that we find ourselves negotiating a deal with such a small amount of money when we know just how devastated the American people are across our country. Think about it. In March, we were able to send $1,200 checks to people and give them $600 in unemployment insurance benefits. And now we're talking about possibly sending a one-time check 8 months later of $600 and reducing that unemployment benefit to $300. That is after 8 months of complete devastation that so many people have faced economically. I mean, I can't even begin to tell you just how embarrassing, shamefully I feel to be a member of Congress fighting for the livelihoods of people across this country. This is one of the wealthiest nations in the world. And we are not embarrassed enough as leaders in our country to see so many people line up to act urgently and accordingly.
Yeah. Yeah, and so thankfully she was one of the progressives that helped to push for these, including people like, as Ro Khanna acknowledged on Twitter, Bernie Sanders has been pushing like from the very beginning of the pandemic for the aid that finally we're getting a sort of minor second dip of. And so thanks to them, but yeah, the idea that the aid is about in almost every way half what it was in the early part of the pandemic, but the deaths are higher now, the hospitalizations are higher now, the case numbers are higher now. So the pandemic's much worse, but the aid is half as much. That's amazing. But it tells you everything you need to know about the government and what they feel their obligation to us is.
It really does. It really does. And it's sad to say, unfortunately, you know, we're very happy that Trump is leaving the White House, even though he's going to be kicking and screaming. Oh my gosh, it gives me so much joy. But we are in for essentially the Obama administration 3.0. And we're going to see, I mean, a lot of people praise a lot of Obama's, you know, effect on the country, but there was a lot of negativity. He's a very centrist president, and Biden coming in also, he's really pandering to the right. And so we're going to see a lot of this. I mean, how disgusting that they weren't going to give anything. And then they're like, all right, here's a few coins. I mean, how Ebenezer Scrooge is that? Right during Hanukkah, right before Christmas. I mean, to be so greedy. I mean, these people could, why can't we just ask Jeff Bezos? Guess what, Jeff? You're giving everybody $1,200, okay? You're giving them all $1,200. You're not even gonna see the dent. They've already probably spent $500 with Amazon alone. So you're gonna give them $1,200 and that's gonna be the end of it. But that would be seen as some crazy communist thing in this country. But we're totally okay with having the government say, double benefits, unemployment. These are people who have worked, paid into unemployment. I mean, these are contributing members of this country, of our society. And we're gonna act like they don't deserve the money that they've put in already.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.